In order to program an API function within Excel, it's necessary to have the Developer tab available. By default, your copy of Excel will probably not have this tab on the ribbon. To enable the Developer tab in Excel, go to the File menu, down to Options, Customize Ribbon, and check the box that says Developer. This activates the Developer tab in the ribbon so you can access the Design Mode insertion functions and get to the Visual Basic and Macro sections. In the Quick Utility sample, in the worksheet labeled General, there is a button whose only purpose is to start Electro and to set your selected unit. The code for the subroutine invoked by clicking this button begins by defining the required variables. These are the string used to set the unit and an integer to inform the program if there are any errors while executing the function. Electro is invoked by defining an object as ies.document. This refers to a Windows registry entry which is linked to Electro, thus defining the object opens up the program. It can also open up other integrated programs depending on what you have registered as ies.document. The code has a pause of a few seconds to make sure that the program is open before sending commands to it. The length unit is read out of the selection list inside the spreadsheet. The selection list works by a combination of the combo box you see plus the values that are written into a hidden column. If we expose the column F by unhiding it, then you can see that there is an association made between the selection box and values written into column F. The value that's selected gets updated as a number in cell F2, and the values appearing in the combo box are written inside of cells F4 to F9. For example, we can have a kilometers unit instead of a meters unit at the top. The Apply Unit combo box will automatically update Electro when you switch it. Switching the value within this box automatically invokes another subroutine called Apply Unit. This subroutine will also invoke ies.document, though in this case, it's expected that Electro is already open and therefore the pause is shorter. The unit selection code works in the same way as when the start button is clicked. The run button in the general worksheet will invoke a routine called Polyline. The Polyline subroutine needs to define more variables than the start or unit subroutines because it's going to be drawing lines from x1, y1 to x2, y2 and is going to cycle through a loop looking for pairs of points to connect with the line. It also needs to receive information back from the integrated program, so the program is invoked, there's a tiny pause to wait for it to open, then a switch is set to valid and a counter set as 1. While valid is set as true, we're going to perform a do loop. At the top of the do loop, we invoke a string which is A combined with the counter number plus the value 3, so at counter equals 1, that will put us at A4, where you see minus 10. It continues for Y1. Then a string will also be created to look at the location 1 further down. If that location contains a number, then Electro will leave valid as true and will also read an X2 and Y2 value. If the next cell down does not contain a number, then it will set valid as false and the do loop will end without trying to draw a line. While it's true, a line will be drawn by invoking Electro as OBJ and invoking the createLine function. This is a command that can be found in the documentation for the integrated API. The format of the command is that it gives the points x1, y1, x2, y2, then it gets back from Electro the number of the segment created and the code that will let you know if there are any errors encountered. After drawing the line, the counter is incremented by 1 so that the loop in total will step through from A4 to A8 and at that point will check as false. It will thus not draw a line and finish the routine. The Rectangle tab contains three different rectangle creation tools. The first one is going to give you two opposite points, x1, y1 and x2, y2, a rounding radius, and then draw the corresponding rectangle. The function that's invoked by clicking the Run button is called Rounded Rectangle. The Rounded Rectangle tool, like the other functions, defines necessary variables to invoke Electro again with a short pause, and will then read values out of the worksheet x1 out of the location B3, x2 out of B4, and so on. It will then draw the rectangle as a series of straight lines, doing a little bit of math on the command itself so that the line begins 1 radius away from the actual corner point. There are 4 straight line creation commands, then there are 4 corner radius commands, all invoking XY locations for the center of the arc, then appropriate angles to round the corners off. The second geometry creation tool defines a rectangle based on the center and then the length and the width. In this case, the function that's invoked is going to read again the values from the corresponding cells, B10 to B13. It then invokes the 2D line creation command in order to draw the rectangle. The final creation tool is a combination of the first two. It defines the center, length, and width of the rectangle and the rounding radius of the corners. From this tool, we have a function which reads the values out of the appropriate cells from the worksheet, performs the math to get the x1, y1 values, but then from there it has all the same information from the original routine for rounding corners, so it simply reproduces the same code as in the first function. The Polygon Creation Tab gives you two different ways of drawing a polygon, which is useful depending on how you think about the geometry or which data you have. Both contain a multiple number of sides, both define the center, but one then defines the size of the polygon by the length of the side, the other by the radius as defined as being the center point to any of the corner points. The radius method for creating the polygon works as usual, by reading a number of variables out of the spreadsheet, the number of sides x and y, centers, and the radius. It then performs a number of calculations that divides 2 pi radians by the number of sides to get the angle of the triangle corresponding to each side. It then assumes that we want to have a horizontal bottom segment, so it starts by drawing a horizontal segment centered at the angle of negative pi by 2. It finds the points half the angle away on either side of negative pi by 2 as x1, y1, and x2, y2, then draws a connecting line. After drawing one line, the for loop cycles back. The counter I is incremented from 0 to 1, then at the end we are going to add one full angle until the angles used in the previous step. It performs the same thing over again, all the way up to the appropriate number of sides, which will then complete drawing the polygon. The other polygon command based on the side length simply works by running the same routine, but it needs to begin by working out what the radius is. When you look at the code, the length is red, then divided by 2, then divided by the side of half the angle in order to work out what the radius is, then the same code is used. Note that accessing the number pi depends on the details of your Excel installation, so for convenient universal code, it was simply defined as a constant in this example.